Good morning, and welcome to Church of the Holy Trinity Guildwood and our Epiphany service of lessons and carols. Stephen is off this week, getting a much-needed Christmas break, and I'm honored to be part of your worship experience. For those who don't know, my name is Denise Byard, and I am the lay pastoral associate here at Church of the Holy Trinity Guildwood and a postulant in the Diocese of Toronto. I'm excited about the good news of Christ and the hope it brings. We're so glad that you can worship with us. You're invited, so if you're joining us online, you're invited to use the live chat feature, which is found on the right-hand side of your screen if it's not in full screen mode. It's wonderful to have you all with us. Please comment, like, or share, and subscribe to our channel.
Today, we honor and acknowledge that this land and locality are on the historical, traditional lands of the Indigenous peoples of what we call Turtle Island and what is commonly called North America. We acknowledge the leadership of Indigenous elders who continue to teach us about what it means to live in a balanced and good way with all creation. May our time of worship together be blessed as we give respect to the first peoples of this land and seek to live in right relationship with ourselves, Creator, and one another. We pray that the Spirit will lead us into all truth, into repentance for the wrongs of the past, and into true reconciliation with our Indigenous brothers and sisters, that we may be partners in healing and peace, to the glory and thanksgiving of God, our Creator.
God of God, light of light, true God of true God,
we give you glory.
Object of the Magi's search, subject of an old man's song, fulfillment of the Baptist preaching. Mary's son, Joseph's son, God's only son.
We give you glory.
Please feel free to kneel, sit, or stand as you are able and as you feel comfortable. Dearly beloved, we are gathered to celebrate with joy the appearance of God's glory in the world through the birth of Jesus, who is Emmanuel, God with us, to reflect upon the visit of the Magi, bringing homage to their king at his birth, and to hear the prophetic words of Anna and Simeon revealing the Christ child as a light to lighten all people. As we rejoice in this, the Word made flesh, who called us out of darkness into light, so we pray that his love and faithfulness may be known in all the world. We pray for the unity and mission of Christ's church and for all who minister the gospel of Christ. We pray for the world that we may have reverence for the natural order and respect for every person made in the image and likeness of God. And we pray for those who stand in need. For the lonely, the fearful, the sick, and the bereaved, and for all who have no one to pray for them. May God, our Father, take us and use us in his service. May he open our eyes to see his glory and equip us to bless his people, now and always. Trusting in the compassion of God and gathering our prayers and praises into one, let us pray as our Savior taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the power and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Eternal God, who by a star led wise rulers and scholars to the worship of your Son, guide by your light the nations of the earth, that the whole world may know your glory. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
The first reading is a reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in a land of deep darkness, on them light has shined. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Great will be his authority, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness from this time onward and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. Listen for the leading of the Spirit. Thanks be to God.
Once in all, they will see.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Arise, shine, for your light has come, and the glory of the Lord has risen upon you. For darkness shall cover the earth, and thick darkness the peoples. But the Lord will arise upon you, and his glory will appear over you. Nations shall come to your light, and kings to the brightness of your dawn. Lift up your eyes and look around. They all gather together. They come to you. Your sons shall come from far away, and your daughters shall be carried in their nurses' arms. Then you shall see and be radiant. Your heart shall thrill and rejoice, because the abundance of the sea shall be brought to you. The wealth of the nations shall come to you. A multitude of camels shall cover you, the young camels of Media and Ephah, all those from Sheba shall come. They shall bring gold and frankincense and shall proclaim the praise of the Lord. Listen for the leading of the Spirit.
But you, O Bethlehem Ephrathah, who are one of the little clans of Judah, from you shall come forth for me one who is to rule in Israel, whose origin is from of old, from ancient days. Therefore we shall give them up unto the time when she who is in labor has brought forth. then the rest of his kindred shall return to the people of Israel. And he shall stand and feed his flock in the strength of the Lord, in the majesty of the name of the Lord his God. And they shall live secure, for now he shall be great to the ends of the earth, and he shall be the one of peace. If the Assyrians come into our land and tread upon our soil, we will raise against them 7 shepherds and 8 rulers. Listen for the leading of the Spirit. Thanks be to God.
The angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth to a virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary, and he came to her and said,
"Greetings, favored one, the Lord is with you."
But she was much perplexed by his words and pondered what sort of greeting this might be.
"Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God, and now you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give to him the throne of his ancestor David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end.
How can this be, since I am a virgin?
The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be holy. He will be called Son of God. And now your relative Elizabeth, in her old age, has also conceived a son. And this is the sixth month of her who was said to be barren. For nothing will be impossible with God.
Here I am, the servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your word.
Listen for the leading of the Spirit.
Thanks be to God.
The fifth reading is from the book of Luke. This was the first registration and was taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David, called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn. Now in that same region there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom he favors." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known what had been told them about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds told them. And Mary treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, just as it had been told to them. Listen for the leading of the Spirit.
Please be seated. Flo, before you sit, if you could let the young people know that they will need to come up soon, upstairs soon after the announcements and offering. Thank you. Those joining online, again, I invite you to subscribe, like, and share our Holy Trinity Guildwood YouTube channel. And if you would like to receive our Together at Trinity, our weekly newsletter, please send us your email address, or you can go to the website and register online. So we have a few exciting things that have happened recently. First, our Christmas concert. There are so many thank yous, so many thank yous. Today is the last day of the year, so if you have not had a chance to watch it, to see it, to attend it, even if you did attend it, please watch it and share with others. We are getting up there. We have over 500 views so far. The more, the better. And please, yes, we want to thank our great top-notch talent. And we had so many in our parish who helped out. Our choir, Flo, Marilyn, and Peter. We had our MC, Linda and the Altar Guild with the great decorations, John and Peter, Lisa Marie, and who helped as well. Our greeters, Eva and Mary Beth. And yes, we are the concert is in support of the Primates World Relief and Development Fund and for Sisters of St. John the Divine Home for the Heart. So if you could go and view the concert would be great. And share, please, of course. And of course, thanks to Nicole, who put in so much work behind the scenes. Robbie prepared donation envelopes. Tim Henniger and, you know, Bruce Fowler and Pat Murray, they lent us items. We had Joe, our student, who was on EV, also Kevin. And thank you, Brian. He's always behind the scenes and so supportive. So thank you, Brian. And today we're trying some new things. I need to look that way. We're trying some new things with the AV, and he's having a bit of fun up there. So thank you. I also want to thank everyone who made special donations for the food cupboard this month. We want to highlight Sir Wilfrid Laurier, the residents of 20 Guildwood Parkway, Club One Studio, and Wellspring. And also, Linda wanted me to ask if anyone would be able to help her next week, her and the team, to put away all these wonderful Christmas decorations that we have, including the nativity scene after the 10:30 service. Please help. For those who are church leaders, a reminder that your reports are due in a month, as we would like to submit the combined reports on February 11th for our annual meeting, the end of February. February will be a fun month, and so we're looking forward to all of that. So our ministries here are supported by prayers, time, energy, and financial gifts of those who worship with us. So many of you have been so generous. Thank you. And your donations have made a wonderful difference. Thank you for your support. If you feel inspired to financially support the impact we are making with our neighbors and our planet, please donate via tap, cash, or check. So I will invite the sides people to come forward. And you can make a donation. I will invite the sides people to come forward. Yes. Yes. If you're new to the community, please don't feel that you have to put anything in the plate. We're just glad to have you here worshiping with us. And so now let's sing the hymn number 128.
Come from the glory.
Blessed be thou, Lord God of Israel, forever and ever. All that is in heaven and on the earth is thine. All things come of thee, and of thine own have we given thee. Amen.
After Jesus was born in Bethlehem in Judah, during the time of King Herod, Magi from the east came to Jerusalem and asked,
"Where is the one who has been born King of the Jews?
We saw his star in the east and have come to worship him."
When King Herod heard this, he was disturbed, and all Jerusalem with him. When he had called together the chief priests and teachers of the law, he asked them where the Christ was to be born.
In Bethlehem, in Judah, for this is what the prophet has written. "But you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah. For all of you will come a ruler who will be shepherd of my people, Israel."
Then Herod called the Magi secretly and found out from them the exact time the star had appeared. He sent them to Bethlehem and said,
"Go and make a careful search for the child. As soon as you find him, report to me, so that I too may go and worship him."
After they had heard the king, they went on their way, and the star they had seen in the east went ahead of them until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw the star, they were overjoyed. On coming to the house, they saw the child with his mother Mary, and they bowed down and worshiped him. Then they opened their treasures and presented him with gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to go back to Herod, they returned to their country by another route. When they had gone, an angel of the Lord appeared to Joseph in a dream.
"Get up, take the child and his mother, and escape to Egypt. Stay there until I tell you, for Herod is going to search for the child to kill him."
So Joseph got up, took the child and his mother during the night and left for Egypt, where he stayed until the death of Herod. And so was fulfilled what the Lord had said through the prophet, "Out of Egypt I called my son." When Herod realized that he had been outwitted by the Magi, he was furious, and he gave orders to kill all the boys in Bethlehem and its vicinity, who were 2 years old and under, in accordance to the time he had learned from the Magi. Then what was said through the prophet Jeremiah was fulfilled.
"A voice was heard in Ramah, weeping in great mourning, Rachel weeping for her children and refusing to be comforted because they were no more."
After Herod died, an angel of the Lord appeared in a dream to Joseph in Egypt and said,
"Get up, take the child and his mother, and go to the land of Israel, for those who were trying to take the child's life are dead."
So he got up, took the child and his mother, and went to the land of Israel. But when he had heard that Archelaus was reigning in Judea in the place of his father Herod, he was afraid to go there. Having been warned in a dream, he withdrew to the district of Galilee, and he went and lived in a town called Nazareth. So was fulfilled what was said through the prophets, He will be called the Nazarene. Listen for the leading of the Spirit.
Thanks be to God.
I invite you all to please stand in body or in spirit. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. And now if I could have the young people join me at the back door as we sing.
Here, thank you. So, I know, adults, if you want to stand and turn, might be easier. The Lord be with you. The wise ones followed God's star to Bethlehem, seeking the Savior.
Let us follow the star.
They found Jesus in Bethlehem and knew they had found the one they were seeking. They fell down and worshipped him, offering him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh.
Let us offer our gifts to the Lord.
So the door is marked. We have the man with the chalk, Joe. So, 20, go for it. 20, we get to mark, we're chalking the door.
Yeah.
Put 20. Yeah?
Oh, good job.
Awesome. So next, we put C. Like Charlie, C, the letter, You could have started higher if you wanted, okay? Now you might need to go to the other side. Then you can go to the other side, Joe. Now an M. And then a B.
Okay.
And tomorrow, maybe like in 12 hours, what year are we? What year? 2024. So, Joe, can you put up 24? Awesome. And so, Caspar, the C is for Caspar, the M is for Melchior, the B is for Balthazar. These are the names that we have identified with the wise men. They followed the star of God's Son, who became human. 2023, soon to be 24 years ago. May Christ bless our church and each person who comes here. Holy God, watch over our going out and our coming in, and fill us with the light of Christ, that we may grow in love, in wisdom, and in faith.
Amen.
And so, adults, there is a little bag by the door. You can take chalk and a prayer blessing and bless your house tonight or tomorrow as well. Followers of Jesus, inspired by the Holy Spirit, serve the world God loves.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.